There was also some pretty wacky stuff that happened on stage. His billionaire bestie Elon Musk was the first to make the victory call.
Do we have a new star? A star is born, Elon. You know, he sent the rocket up 2 weeks ago, and I saw that rocket, and I saw it coming down. I saw it. When it left, it was beautiful, shiny white. When it came down, it didn't look so pretty. It was going 10,000 miles an hour. And I called Elon. I said, Elon, was that you? He said, yes, it was. I said, who else can do that? Can Russia do it? No. Can China do it? No. Can the United States do it other than you? No. Nobody can do that. I said, that's why I love you, Elon. But he's a character. He's a special guy. He's a super genius. We have to protect our geniuses. We don't have that many of them. We have to protect our super geniuses.
I told you. A little wacky at times. He is popular, though, isn't he? Let's go to Alison Petrowski live in Washington, D.C. for us with that breaking news that Kamala Harris has just called President-elect Donald Trump. Ali, good morning to you again. The call only lasted a few minutes.
Yeah, this is according to one of Kamala Harris's aides. This call took place within the last hour, Carl. The vice president called him to congratulate him on his win. And I'll quote what the aide said, that they discussed the importance of a peaceful transfer of power and being a president for all Americans. And as you mentioned, Carl, that call only lasting a number of minutes. Kamala Harris due to talk here at Howard University in a couple of hours from now. We are just in the Secret Service line about to get our gear swept, hence me with my backpack on. Carl, at the moment, we will head through in a moment, but we are running a little bit behind schedule. She is expected to address the nation at 4 p.m. DC time, so a couple of hours from now we'll see how that plays out and if she is in fact punctual. But the vice president has had a lot of strong celebrity reaction this morning right across the board. Let's read some of that reaction. Firstly, from Christina Applegate. Why? Give me your reasons why. My child is sobbing because her rights as a woman may be taken away. From Cardi B, who campaigned for Kamala Harris on the road this week, she just simply said, I hate your bad. And look, from the world's most famous athlete, Carl, LeBron James, he said, heavy on my heart and my mind with this AM, my princess. Promise to protect you with everything I have and more. We don't need their help. Carl, this morning, the DNC chairman, Jamie Harrison, has indicated that he will not be running for re-election in January. Very few Democrats have popped up their heads this morning to say much. We have not heard from the incumbent, Joe Biden, so all eyes on the White House to see if he talks today, because, Carl, he will bear a lot of this blame because of the result of last night's crushing defeat.
Ali Petrowski on the move like Dora the Explorer this morning. We'll let you go in through security and we'll see what happens from Kamala Harris a little bit later. Thank you for that.